Good afternoon, President, fellow Toastmasters, and beloved guest. When I say 9/11, what do you all think about immediately?
Tweet towers.
Yes, 9/11, one of the most deadliest terrorist attack that happened on Twin Tower on September 11, 2001. And it killed close to 3,000 people who are very innocent. None of them know that they're going to die on that day when they went into the office that morning. 15 years later, on the same day, September 11, 2016, I got a call from my brother in India. He said, my dad passed away due to heart attack. Oh no! How could you leave us so early, Dad? It was so shocking for all of us as I met him the previous week and he was so healthy and active. It was unbelievable to us. And it was so painful for us to believe that he is no more with us. It was a great shock for all of us. 2 weeks later, my close friend Surinder, who studied together with me in university and also lived in Singapore, passed away due to cancer at the age of 44. He just had fever symptoms and the doctor couldn't diagnose his cancer 2 days before his death. Why is life so cruel to these people? Within a span of 2 weeks, I lost two of my close ones. It really struck me so hard and it was totally devastating. And I thought, life is very uncertain and it doesn't give people more time to react or correct themselves. So I took a step back and I was thinking, what should I do if something happens to me? And what should I do before something happens to me? So I thought it's a good platform to share with me, with you all Toastmasters, because I think none of you here have come with a 100% guarantee to live till a certain age. Am I right? So does any of you have a 100% guarantee that you're going to live till 80 or 90? Anybody? That's a reality. So I was just looking back and I was thinking through, what are we supposed to do? And I want to share that with you. Spend more time with family and leave your kids some legacy. Work is meant to be only for 8 hours, but we are all very obsessed with work and stay quite late at work. And even when we come back from work, we carry the work back to home. Let our kids not have an impression that their dad is so busy with work and after coming back, the dad is busy engaged with laptops, smartphones or television shows. Let us not do that. Let's give some ears to the small kids to hear the little stories about the fights they had with their friends at the park or some small gossips they had at school. I recently read a quote by American actress Dolly Parton and it was very applicable to all of us here. She said, don't make yourself so busy to make a living that you forget to make a life. And I think most of us are doing the same. So we are trying to force for a living but we forget the life. And the other thing I want to remind you all is to show gratitude and be kind to everybody. These days, the world is so competitive and the work schedule and everything, life is so hectic. And most of us forgot how to smile. We all only know how to use a smiley in the smartphones. So, how many of us say thanks to Andy who helped to clean a table at a food court? Or how many of us smile at a stranger when we see them in the streets? Most of us don't do that. Let us try to show gratitude from now on if you're not doing it in the past. When you go out from the Toastmaster meeting room, smile at people when you look at them. When your mother or your wife cook food for them, for you, appreciate their efforts. When you help her clean your houses or take care of the kids, say a small thank you to them. Expressing gratitude, it's the simplest thing every human can do and it's absolutely free. So, I also wanted to remind you people or just to, based on the experience I thought, it's good to have some financial planning to ease the burden for your family after your absence in case you're not there. If you have small kids, school-going kids and who are just studying, try to get some endowment policies to cover for the university education. Even something happens to you in your early stage, the kid's early stage, the insurance company is going to pay out and they'll be getting the money whatever they want for the education. And for those living in private property, make sure you have a mortgage protection scheme to cover your property loan. For those staying in HDB, not to worry, the home protection scheme is automatically covered. And I also suggest you to look at your insurance policies and see if you have enough coverages after you pass away for cover your family expenses. And other thing I want to remind you, most of them used to forget, is CPF fund nomination. So make sure you have a nomination for your CPF funds to be transferred to your spouse or your kids. In case you have not done it, it's a very simple process. Just go to the CPF website, make an e-appointment with CPF, and walk into the office. It's just a 5 to 10 minutes process. I recently did it. I didn't do it previously. Last week I went and did my CPF nomination. The other thing and final thing I want to tell you is, write a will and register with the will registry. You don't need to be rich to write a will. Anybody over age of 21 can make a will. A will is a legal document to give instructions, specific instruction on how to distribute your assets. NTUC is regularly conducting a will writing workshop on a monthly or ad hoc basis. I've registered for the will writing workshop as well in November. So in short, I want to remind you again that life is very short. So embrace every single moment of your life. Be happy. Lead a scintillating life. Leave your kids a legacy. Stop complaining. Apologize for your mistakes. And make sure you have enough insurance coverages to cover your family's financial burden in your absence. Back to you, Persuade.